Hello friends, this is Durga from IIT University. This video is part of a course called as CCA Data Analyst in which HiveScoop and Impala are covered quite extensively. If you want to learn any of these technologies or prepare for the certification, you can enroll for our course for $10 by going through the information in description. Also, we provide something called as Big Data Developer Labs. If you want to sign up for the labs and practice, you can actually go to the description and click on the link to get details about the labs. If you are not subscribed to our channel yet, please do so by clicking on the subscribe button and also click on notify button so that you get notified whenever we create free content as part of our channel. Let us understand the flow of scoop import with Hive import option. There is a control argument called as verbose. We can use that along with any scoop import command and we should be able to generate a lot more logs than typical logs, which will give us idea of what is happening internally. So in this case, I'll be running scoop import command with Hive import option as well as the verbose, and we'll actually review the logs so that we understand what is happening internally. So here I'm saying scoop import and then connect JDBC colon MySQL colon MS dot itversity.com 3306, username retail_user, password itversity, table orders. I want to perform the Hive import and hence Hive import. I want to specify the Hive database, which is nothing but training_scoop_retail in our case. Then Hive overwrite. So in case if the table already exists, I want to overwrite the existing data in the table. And then I want to use this additional control argument called as verbose to generate a lot more logs. You can use this verbose even without Hive import options like this. So verbose is a typical control argument that can be applied on any scoop command. Now I can actually say 2> and then I should be able to give the file name, which is nothing but scoop import.error. Also, if there are any standard out messages, I just want to redirect to scoop import.out. So whatever logs are generated as part of this scoop import command, I want to redirect into error as well as out. Whatever is generated as part of error will get into this file. Whatever is generated as part of the standard out will get into this file. If you don't use this, then the size of the logs is too much and we will not be able to go to the beginning of the logs and then review from the start. With this, as the logs are redirected to the files, we should be able to open the file and we should be able to review the logs from the beginning till the end to understand what is happening internally. Now I am hitting enter. It will take care of running the scoop import. However, as we are redirecting the standard out as well as standard error into the files, you will not be seeing any information here. Now the scoop import is done. We should be able to run ls-ltr scoop import then star. We can see the files here. One is scoop import.out and second one is scoop import.error. No logs are generated as part of standard out and hence this is empty. However, there are logs generated as part of this file. We should be able to review by saying view scoop import.err and hit enter. Now you can go through these logs to understand what is happening internally. So first it is actually running this get column info query, which is nothing but this one. Okay, here it failed. That's why it completed fast. As we haven't specified the database name as part of the scoop import command in connect, it actually failed saying that no database specified. Now I have to rerun this. I have to say scoop import and then connect retail_db, then rest of the stuff. In this case, the logs will be overwritten in these files because we are using only one greater than symbol, and hence a new log file will be created with this name and it will actually have the logs related to this import command only. Whatever is there in those files will be overwritten by this command. Now it is taking a lot more time to perform the scoop import. Once it is done, we should be able to review the logs by running this command, and then we should be able to view by saying view scoop import.l, and we'll go through step by step to understand what is happening internally. If you look at the output of this ls-ltr command, the scoop import.l is quite big compared to the previous one. Now I can open this scoop import.l and then we can go through these logs here. As part of get column info query, it is running this command and then it is actually getting the details with respect to column names and data types. Here you can see all those details. So these are the columns which we have and these are the data types. Using this information, it actually created a Java file in this location. Once that Java file is created, it actually compiled into a jar file. You can see the jar file location here. Once the jar file is created, using that jar file, it actually submitted the MapReduce job. You can scroll down and see what is happening before submitting the MapReduce job. You know that before submitting the MapReduce job, it will actually get the split sizes, and using those split sizes, it will actually build the queries. As the number of mappers is 4, there will be 4 splits, and for each split, it will actually build a query, and you can get all that information here. You can see that split size is 17,220 because the min of order ID is 1 and max of order ID is 68,883. If you compute the difference and then divide by 4, you will get the split size. Now using this information, it actually builds the queries like this. the first query have the already greater than or equal to 1 and already less than 17,222. The second query have the already greater than or equal to 17,222 and already less than 34,443. The third query have the already greater than or equal to 34,443 and already less than 51,663. And the fourth query have already greater than or equal to 51,663 and already less than or equal to 68,883. Using these queries, it actually fetched the data from the source and then imported into the staging location. Staging location is nothing but /user/training orders. Here it completes the copying data into the staging location. It has copied all 68,883 records into the staging location. After that, it have actually created the table in Hive database. If the table does not exist, if the table already exists, it will just ignore because it is using this if not exists option. And then it has ran this load data in path command with overwrite. That's why the data in the existing table is overwritten as we have used Hive overwrite. So you can actually understand what is happening internally by running the scoop import with verbose. This will give you the clarity about the scoop execution flow with respect to import with Hive options. Now I'll be running the same scoop import command. However, this time I'll be removing this Hive overwrite and hence the data is supposed to be appended to existing table. So here I'm saying scoop import and then copy pasting command from here to here and then copying this final line. Hit enter. Once the import is done, we will actually review the file scoopimport.l and see what is happening as part of the final steps while copying data into the Hive table. Now I'm saying scoopimport.l using view and then going to the last part of this file. You can see that it is running this create table if not exists command to create table if it does not exist. If it exists, it will just ignore. And then when it comes to loading the data into the table, it is actually running this load data in path into table option. As you have specified, it has ran this command to get data into this Hive table called as orders. In this case, it is using into table compared to overwrite into table when we actually use Hive overwrite, which means it is actually appending into the existing table than overwriting the data in the existing table. Now, if we run the scoop import with create Hive table option, so let's say scoop import and then rest of the command till here, then let's say create Hive table and then this final part to redirect the logs into the corresponding files. As the scoop import is done, we can view this file called as scoopimport.l. We can go to the last part of this file. Till here it is same. It has successfully imported 68,883 records. However, after this, it is supposed to be running these two commands. One is create table command. In this case, it have no if not exists option, which means it will try to create the table. If the create table is successful, it will also run this load data command. But as the table already exists and as there is no if not exists option here, it is failing here itself. And hence, this command never run. As this command is not run, the data in this location is not moved to this table. As data is not moved to the table, this location still exists. That's why if we use create Hive table and if the target table already exists, it will just leave the staging location as is and we have to clean it up and then rerun if you have to rerun the scoop import command into the table.